Everyone must feel himself like a pop star, you know, or like an actress on a stage, and that all this crowd comes only for them.
But I think the biggest thing is I don't think about really much. You know, once I get to a swim meet, I've done all the training and I've done everything that I need to do to get to that point. And now it's just time to put my goggles on and dive off the block and race.
Come out and I work hard every day, so when I go on the track, I know I put in the work. Because that's the thing that plays on your mind when you're on the track, you're wondering if I did enough starts and stuff. So I make sure I put in the work, so when I go there, I have nothing on my mind, I'm really relaxed and ready to go. You go out there, some people break down mentally.
You know, because I think if you think too much about it, you can kind of psych yourself out. Relax, you know, you've gotten to that point, just jump in the water, have fun, and whatever happens, happens. And you know, if you don't like what happens, you can train and you can change things.
I think it's the most important things for each athlete. How you warm up your body depends in which shape you're gonna be during the trainings, during the competition.
I take time every day before I get in the water and then just to stretch my muscles up and really get loose and get ready to swim.
I do strides instead of jogging around the track, so I start off doing 5 slow ones, then I kind of pick it up after the next 5, and then the last couple strides I really put some pace into it to get my legs warm up and let them know we're going to do some work.
Some stretching on the floor, legs, arms, body, neck, head, brain.
Most of all, my calves and stuff, I slightly stretch my hamstring. It's very important to make sure your hamstrings are stretched because it's very delicate, and when it goes, it's really bad because I've been there. I've torn my hamstring earlier and it's put me out for season, so it's very important to really make sure the hamstrings are stretched well.
I do my warm-up 40-45 minutes minimum. Such a great protection from the injury. Don't stop your training without warm-up. This is my words.
And then I put my spikes on, do some strides like about 5 to really warm my legs up. So that's pretty much my routine warm-up in half an hour. I'm kind of quick, so I do it quickly.
When I go to compete, you know, I always have my headphones on, I'm always listening to music just to make sure that I'm ready, that I'm in the zone, I'm, you know, focused and ready to go.
Crowd, the cameramen, they always try to catch some emotion in my face. And just to avoid all this extra attention, I cover myself for better concentration, for focus. Do you have YOG DNA? Yes, I do.
I had the same routine. I walk out, dry off the block, put the towel down right in front of the block, stretch my legs, take my headphones out, get up on the block, and do my normal little that thing, and then that's it. Every race, I've done it since I was probably 11 or 12 years old.
Yes, I have
YOG
DNA.
To all athletes, eat well and stay healthy.